I've never been the one to raise my hand. That was not me, and now that's who I am. Because of you, I am standing tall. My heart is full of endless gratitude. You were the one who got me through. Now I can see, and I believe it's only just beginning. This is what we dream about. Is all I need to know. I've learned to love myself in spite of me, and I've learned to walk the road that I believe. But the only question with me now is, do I make you proud? Stronger than
Normandie B. Pizarro will now begin. Thank you.
Mga kasama, napabot ang ating kagalang-galang ng panawi pantangan. Justice, Normandie B. Pizarro, senior member, Defense Division, Court of Appeals. Kanyang taong puso pagkasalamat sa parangal na ginawad natin sa kanya sa umagang ito.
Students, cadets, or visitors from Philippine Air Force. To other visitors, officers, cadets, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. The Philippine National Police Academy, in its mission and extension service function, is indeed very proud and happy that you visited us here. It shows that we have strengthened ties with you. I hope that you always visit us for the coming years. I hope that you, in your short stay in this academy, you will enjoy. So, each and everyone, welcome.
Thank you very much, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Allow me to proceed with my task to introduce our guest of honor and speaker. Our guest of honor and speaker, so first light, the 7th day of February, I will not anymore mention the year, in Sampal of Manila. He is happily married to Congresswoman Catalina Yunin Pizarro of the ABS party list, and they are blessed with five wonderful children. Our honoree was admitted to the bar in the year 1975, and he also became a respected academician at the UE College of Law, teaching criminal law, trial technique, criminal procedure, special procedure. This was from 1989 to 1993. And he was also the founding president of the UA Law Alumni Association from 1986 to 1987. May continue. He was also became the founding president of the Prosecutors League of Manila in 1987 to 1989 on two consecutive terms. In the year 2002, 2003 after 2005, our honoring was the executive vice president and director for Quezon City RTC Judges Association or the Philippine Judges Association. He is also a consistent recipient of various awards and recognitions. He was recognized as the Outstanding Alumni Hall of Fame awardee of the UA Law Alumni Association with Supreme Court Justice Dante Tinga and Mayor Alfredo Lim as lead awardees, and also Secretary Supreme Court Justice Hilario Davide Jr. in the year 2003. He was then an awardee at the top in disposition of cases for year 2006 during the Court of Appeals anniversary on February 1, 2007. He was acclaimed as the Olerian Ama awarded for the year 2007 during the National Mothers and Fathers Day celebration on June 7, 2007. He was an awardee in the UA Law Alumni Honor Roll year 2010 on September 22, 2010. Our honoree was also the recipient of the citation, one of the 8 justices with 0 case backlog as of November 30, 2010 in the Court of Appeals. In September 2, 2008, today, our honoree is the incumbent chairman on the Committee on Security and Safety of the Court of Appeals. Likewise, he is the chairman of the Ganda CAA Movement and Grounds and Justification at also at the Court of Appeals. So, without much further ado, ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming our honoree, the senior member, 7th Division, Court of Appeals of Manila, Justice Normandie B. Pizarro.
Tiga sebanyak, please. Expecting to have a picnic or excursion in this place, PNPA, Camp Castaneda. We did not expect that we are to be received with this very elaborate preparation. In fact, the first time in my life to be an honoree in a parade passing in review. And so I will dispense with my reading, my speech, because I have not prepared one. Anyway, lawyers are taught to be talkative and impromptu, and so please bear with me. I was tasked to share my advices to the cadets, to the young people, to the future hope of the fatherland, the PNPA cadets, as well as the Air Force cadets. Pwede ba? Palakpakan po natin sila. Let me now pay my respects to the guru of the PNPA Academy, Police Chief Superintendent. They call this General before, and now Antonio L. Ticano, the Director of this Academy. My colleague in the Court of Appeals, if it is in the military, in the judiciary, he could also be considered as bimedal. A colleague in the Regional Trial Court of Quezon City, now with the Court of Appeals, Justice Samuel H. Garland. I was told that the contingent is a visitor today. Let me pay my respect and acknowledge the presence of Commandant of the Philippine Air Force Officer Candidate School, Lieutenant Colonel Bueno Buena. The Assistant Commander, Commandant, PAF Officer, Major Clarence Abellera. I think he is the MC. When he said, by way of salutation to Justice Garland, my brother, I looked and stared at his face. Kung kamukha niya si Justice Garland, at baka kapatid sa labas, yung pala kapatid sa Mason, si Senior Superintendent Cesneros. I hope I have not violated protocol, but it is not yet too late. We are happy. Even before our coming, you have gifted us the services of a 1 peso consultant, a product of the PNPA. Piso ang sweldo niya sa amin. Labor of love, your former director of the PNPA, General Baligi Tira. Let me pay my respects and acknowledge also the presence of the Philippine Air Force Training Course. Mabagsik ang mga pangalan nito. Class Mabalasig and Class Kampilan. The PNPA Sergeant Officers, the Cadet Corps, Cadet Corps, other guests, ladies and gentlemen. Ako po ay nagpapasalamat sa inyong pagtanggap sa amin. We thought there was no ceremony at all, no elaboration, so to speak. But for the first time in our lives, we were honored this kind of an honor. So, hindi po namin makakalimutan to. Mapasalamat kami ng malaki. Dati, nasa panaginip lang yung ganitong pangyayari. And so, perhaps with great amount of nostalgia and the great amount of misgiving, let me just tell you my beginnings to the Commandant and to the Cadet Corps. Some 40 years ago, Kaming mga kabataan, dalawang ambisyon namin. Kung hindi po mapunta sa US Navy, mas gusto namin mapunta sa PMA. Philippine Military Academy. I think this is now the equivalent of the Philippine Military Academy. Kung ako po ay nagtuloy ng panahon na yon, at hindi naman ako naging mapalad, ako po sana ay PMA Class 70. I am proud to say that one of the biggest producers of PMAers, if not the biggest, is our public school, Cubao High School. Class 70, as you know, is a very decorated class. I would have been probably a part of the honors of being an officer in uniform. Ang akin pong mga naging kasama at naging best friend ko na rin, it started with a streamer hung on the wall of our alma mater, a public school. Kami po ay mahirap ang mga magulang, kaya public school. But that was then the time when the Tomasian school system was at its very best, the public school system. The streamer says, congratulations to the 1960 valedictorian, the new chief of staff, Angelo T. Reyes. And so, I hope he is now resting in peace. I know, just like all of you, he valued honor. To him, life is honor. He did it for his honor, honor of the family, and honor of the service. He became chairman of our alumni movement. I was so privileged to be the president of our alumni and saw him how he worked. Kaya hanggang ngayon, naiingit pa rin ako sa pagiging kadete ninyo at pagiging opisyales ng mga pamunuan. Having said that, hindi naman po kami nalalayo sa inyong inalalagyan. We are the pillars of the justice system, criminal justice system. Alam niyo po yon, the law enforcement agencies, of which the police, the various police enforcement agencies, the prosecution service, the judiciary, the penal institution, and of course the community. I was tasked to say something about my message for the youth. Ako po ay nasasayahan at nakikita ko kayo. Kapag wala pong disiplina sa buhay ng tao, walang paruroonan ng tao. The Filipino has been known to be a good disciplined man, especially abroad. But there is some setback when he is in his native land. Kaya ako, naiingit sa inyo, samantalahin nyo, mga kadete kong mga anak, mga kapatid, ang inyong matututunan dito sa academy. This is the best place for you to get optimum character education. Yung matututunan nyo rito ay hindi matatapatan ng kahit na anong paaralan. Ako po ay nasisiyahan, naalala ko, noong panahon namin, ang isa kong best friend was a two-star PNP officer. He was our platoon commander. Ako po ang first sergeant. In a grading score of 600, we got 596, only 40 merits. I am proud to say that we were the 1965 champion of the PMT Open Drill nationwide. ang aking pong kasama, ang best friend ko, sumaka bilang buhay na si General Catalunya, class 17. Wala bang palakpakan dyan? Huwag tayo masyadong seryoso kasi I know the PNP is a very disciplined group, pero maruhusay din pala kayong umambos. Inambos nyo kami ngayong araw nito, General. So, wala akong dalumpate at I will have to seek from my research. These times are trying times. You have always been in the news as a group of enforcement officers. You have never been under greater scrutiny than today. Patunayan natin ang character education natin dito ay tatagal. Kumbaga sa cellphone, hindi kayo maglulubat. Ituloy ninyo at magsilbi tayo sa bayan. There is a saying, to test the character of a man, give him power. To test the character of a man, give him a gun. Sana huwag kayong matulad sa mga nababalita. Give them power, give them gun, and they think they are supreme. Civilian authority over the military. Attitude to me is the most important. Between somebody who is very intelligent and somebody who is not so intelligent, or even a mangmang, mas gusto pa ang mahina ang isip. Bakit? Pwede mong pandayin sa anyong gusto mong ihubog sa kanya para maging makabayan, para maging mapagmahal, at para maging makadiyos. Huwag niyong kalilimutan niya. What you need is performance. Sometimes we have the mistaken notion of managing through witnesses. All of us have witnesses. Let us identify the strengths of each and every one of our people and staff. Make your staffing pattern according to strengths. Weaknesses are there, but they should be neutralized if not managed. Tandaan niyo po yun. Performance, therefore, is needed, not conformance. Pag conformance, you will end up being a bootlegger. You know what is a bootlegger? Kung ano sabihin ng boss, saludo kayo ng saludo, tawa kayo ng tawa, tungo ng tungo. You will be a bootlegger. Do not be a bootlegger. You should speak out politely and help shape the mindset of your superior and help the organization. I recall that lines of Aldous Huxley, while you are now in schooling, the end of life is not knowledge. The end of life is not knowledge. But action. Very few are given by God the opportunity to make a difference. But once you are given that opportunity, you grab it. Very few are given the opportunity to make a difference. Once the same confronts you, you grab it. Imagine, you are 1,000 cadets. Just think and do one good thing daily. isang magandang bagay lang. Nakakita ka ng kalat sa kalye, nakakita ka ng upos ng sigarilyo. Pinulot mo. Sabay pala kayo, 1,000 kayo naglilinis. Hindi ba maganda yan? You are now in your formative stage. We are now speaking from where we were, where we stand rather. Kami po ay may konting karanasan na, nahulog na kami sa kanal, natapa na kami. So the best thing to do is when you are confronted with a man of achievement, yan, pag nakita nyo ang mga officialis nyo sa academy, ako ang ginagawa ko ganito. Pinag-aaralan ko ang lakas ng tao. Study their strengths so that they could be living examples. Imagine, you collect all the strengths of the people you meet. You will be equipped with a lot of strength. Mahirap na kayong matumba. You will never live mediocre lives. You will always be champions. Remember also the mythical story of the extra miler. You decided to wake up at 5 o'clock in the early morning so that you will be the early bird until you discover somebody woke up at 4 o'clock, naunahan kayo. But if you woke up early, work extra, say 4 hours a day, in 1 year, you're ahead by 60 days or so. So you will always be a champion. Do not forget that. Gayong bata pa kayo, you, in your formative stage, you embrace the proper character traits. Do not settle for mediocrity. Alam nyo, mediocrity, ordinaryong buhay. Below that, you will contribute to this quarter problem of the country. Let us strengthen the middle intelligentsia group of the country, of which you will soon belong. So having said that, may I say that the test of organization is not genius. It is the capacity to make common people achieve uncommon performance. Always excel, excel, excel. I remember he was 5 years ahead of me when he was telling me, pare, nag-aral ako. I studied abroad, I studied in Harvard, I studied in AIM. Nag-aral ako ng nag-aral. I even took up law. And so I said, what happened? After the first day, I enrolled at the University of the East College of Law. Sabi niya, bumaha hanggang hita. What happened? Nag-drop na ako sa klase. He was the late Angelo T. Reyes. So my message for you today is struggle, do not settle for mediocrity, be champions, contribute to your career, contribute to the honor of your family, contribute to country. Magkawanggawa kayo. Above all, huwag kalilimutan ng Diyos. Maging maawain kayo sa kapwa at tuloy-tuloy yan. Maawa sa inyo ang Diyos. Having said that, let me now leave to you my 5 booklets, General, for me to share to the cadets. I happen to be the commencement speaker of all the graduates of our alma mater, the University of the East, last year. Modesty aside, I was so humbled. They kept on asking me for copies of this speech and this CD. I will be leaving five to you. Please share that to the cadets. And I'm sure, with all humility, they will learn a lot from it. Attorney Lucio, will you please give my mentors to General? Ito pong sinipi kong ito, kailangan po panoodin nyo muna yung CD at saka seryoso, you invite your cousins, even your parents. I say this because of the reactions of people. Siguro nakakapag-imprenta na ako ng 2,000. Madisesay na nagandaan daw sila. Maraming nag-enroll sa College of Law, maraming nabigyan ng inspirasyon. They asked me to talk about my experiences as a youth leader and as a worker in government and in the private sector. I'd like to share this, General, to the cadets. Maybe hand it to you now. Ako po, pag nasabing magsalita kayo tungkol sa sarili ninyo, yun ho ang pinakaayaw kong gawin. It is like saying, I love my own, my native land, but since you tasked me to talk about myself, General, so I hope you will beg my indulgence. So having said that, kami po ay makikipagbarilan lang sana rito. Eh, inambos nyo naman kami. Ito po ang aming security group. Nakakayaman sabihin, mahirap ang buhay sa gobyerno. 75 years na po ang Court of Appeals. Huwag niyo nang pamamalita. Ngayon lang po sila makakapag-firing. Tumayo ngayon lahat at you wave your hands to the cadet. So, congratulations to all of you. I know there are also youth groups here. Oh, mas marami sa inyo ang kababaihan, magaganda. Isa lang ang gustong sabihin kung ipapaitulot nyo. Ang babaeng bata, walang kwenta kung dalawang bagay meron siya. Number one, pag matigas ang ulo. Pag matigas ang ulo ng babae, walang paruroonan. Tandaan niya. O ba't nagtuturuan kayo? Pagtamad ang babae, yan, dumaming turo. Wala rin kwenta. So, huwag kayong nagtitigas ang ulo. You strive hard. Ang mga magulang namin, mahirap noon. Ako po, nagsishine ako, nagtitinda ng comics nung araw. At natutuwa naman lahat na pagtapos ng mga magulang. Kaming lahat. Ang anak ko kahapon, natuwa ako. At yung pamangkinong babae, pareho na silang doktor. Kanakaan tayo. So, may silang po ang buhay ng tao. I think it was Napoleon Hill who said, man has three parts of his time. One-third is sleep time. Kailan matulog din kayo? Kasi may sinasabing chemical process yan eh. I think it is cortisol. If you don't sleep well, this chemical will not generate in the body. It will be bad to you. Second is your work time. Second, third. And the last third is your free time. In your free time, you do anything as it pleases you. You can go up to the mountains, you can swim, you can eat even a live chicken. Do not be guilty as long as you do not injure the rights of people. But in the three parts of your time, you can invade your a portion of your sleep time. and a portion of your free time to become an enlarged work time. When you do that, you are tend to be an achiever. You are tended to be a successful person. So, yun lang po ang aking mensahe. Magandang umaga sa inyo lahat.
Thank you very much, sir. For the presentation of the mental to the audience, Justice Normandie B. Pizarro.
I'm never been the one to raise my hand. That was not me. And now that's who I am. Because of you, I am standing tall. My heart is full of endless gratitude. You were the one, the one who got me through. Now I can see. Is all I need to know. I've learned to love myself in spite of me, and I've learned to walk the road that I believe. But the only question with me now is, do I make you proud? Stronger. Do I make you? Do I make you?